Hello and welcome to Pfeiffer Vacuum. My name is Jan Hendrik, and in this short clip, I will talk about an important topic in vacuum technology, pumping speed and gas throughput. May you have heard that a vacuum pump has, for example, 18 cubic meters per hour or 300 liters per second pumping speed. If not, you will find this information in almost every data sheet for vacuum pumps. But what does it actually mean, and why do we have such a wide range of different pumps with different suction speeds? Basically, the pumping speed S is the mean volume flow through a cross section of the inlet port of a vacuum pump. The exact determination of pumping speed is described in the ISO standard. The unit used is always volume per time, but often depends on the pumping principle of vacuum pumps. The most common units are cubic meters per hour or liter per second. Each pumping principle has a characteristic pumping speed curve, where the pumping speed is plotted against the pressure prevailing in the system. In the case of gas type dependent pumping principles, the pumping speed characteristics for individual gases are also given. Gas type dependent means that there are pumping principles that have a higher pumping speed for certain gases than for others. For example, turbomolecular pumps have a higher pumping speed for nitrogen than for helium. Scroll pumps, on the other hand, operate independently of gas type, so they have approximately the same pumping speed for helium and nitrogen. In simple terms, pumping speed can be thought of as the volume that a vacuum pump delivers in a given time. However, this volume does not indicate the amount of gas that will be pumped, as this is always dependent on the pressure in the system. To better describe the pumped quantity of gas, the definition of gas flow Q is used, which is defined as the product of pumping speed and pressure. We are no longer talking about volume, but about the amount of gas delivered by a pumping system in a given period of time. This volume of gas pumped through a pumping system always remains constant. Only the two factors, pressure and pumping speed, change in the system. I would like to show you an everyday example that illustrates the two concepts explained before. If we consider the human lungs, we can assume that it works similar to a vacuum pump and has a pumping speed of about 4 liters per second for air. The amount of oxygen absorbed by the lungs depends on the pressure in the environment. When we are on Mount Everest, for example, the pumping speed of the lungs is still 4 liters per second. Due to the lower pressure, less oxygen is being transported into the body. Therefore, we would have to breathe more or increase the inhalation pressure to deliver the same amount of oxygen to the lungs. In the next video, we will explain the terms base pressure. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel.